Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear viewers, welcome back to the third and final segment of our today's Islam and Life. Islam and Life is a program for us to understand Islam better. Today we are continuing the topic of medicines, and also the continuing the topic, one of the medicines is missing salah. Today is the part two. We'll learn lots of things from our Shaykh, and we also heard some questions from our audience, and we also have some questions already in our place. So we'll try to answer them accordingly. Without further delay, let's get back to our Shaykh. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Shaykh, thank you very much for your lectures on the first two segments. We learned lots of things from your lectures. I would like to request you to summarize your lectures in a short bit so we can answer the questions what we already have to our audience, please.
Jazakallah khair. MashaAllah. So my brothers and my sisters, as we are saying that as far as Salah is concerned, it's made compulsory by Allah Azza wa Jalla in the five times daily. And it's for benefiting us. Allah Azza wa Jalla will grant us the benefit. In one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained what is the benefit of Salah. So as Allah Azza wa Jalla is concerned, I have mentioned the ayat from Surah Al-Ankabut, verse 45. The Salah prevents from immodesty and those things which are considered as sins, as a crime. A person is prevented from these kind of things because of Salah. A person who sincerely prays to Allah Azza wa Jalla, he won't be doing anything which is immodest. He won't be doing anything which is against the good conduct, etc., etc. i.e. he won't commit any crimes, commit any sins. So that was the benefit mentioned by Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Quran. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives a very practical example. In the hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 538, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, أَرَأَيْتُمْ لَوْ أَنَّ نَهْرًا بِبَابِ أَحَدِكُمْ يَغْسِلُ فِيهِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ خَمْسًا مَا تَقُولُ ذَلِكَ يُبْقِي مِنْ دَرْنِهِ قَالُوا لَا يُبْقِي مِنْ دَرْنِهِ شَيْئًا قَالَ فَذَلِكَ مِثْلُ الصَّلَوَاتِ الْخَمْسِ يَمْحُ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْخَطَايَا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the example of the five daily prayers, a person who prays the five daily prayers, his and her example is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, if a person has a river flowing by his house, and in that river he has an opportunity to bathe five times, will that person have any kind of stain remaining on his body? Rasulullah gave the example, if a person has a stream or a river flowing by his house and he and she, they have a chance to bathe there five times daily, will they have any kind of stain or a mess remaining on their body? Sahaba replied, Ya Rasulullah, nothing will be remaining on his body from the stain. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, this is the example of the five daily prayers. If a person prays five daily prayers, Allah Azza wa Jalla removes all the sins, all the obstacles, all the difficulties, all the problems from his life, and his life is clean and neat and tidy, and his life is like ever fresh. He has nothing as concern in his life. So these are the benefit Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in the hadith, and Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned in the Quran, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith. Inshallah, we'll continue with the little summary at the end as well after the question.
Shaykh, we already received some questions through our audience, through Facebook and social media. So first questions, it's regarding the Salah. It's a very wonderful question for family. Mm-hmm. How should husband and wife pray congregational salah at home?
MashaAllah. Very nice question. That how can husband and wife pray their congregational salah at home? For example, if the husband could not make his way to the masjid and he got late, now they want to pray salah at home. Now, at home, Salah can be prayed in a congregation, in a jama'ah, with husband and wife, no problem. The procedure is exactly same as we do in the masjid. The husband will become the imam, okay? However, the wife, she will not stand parallel with the imam. She will stand behind the imam. Like we normally stay behind the imam up to about 6 foot or 5 foot away from the imam. Similarly, she will stay away from the imam, okay? And then she will follow the husband, and the husband will lead the salah. He will act as an imam, and she will be follower of the imam, and they will pray the salah in congregation. And inshallah, because of praying congregational salah at home, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give them the extra rewards. So this is, mashallah, very nice question. Through this question, we have learned that if the husband could not make his way to masjid for any reasons, okay, and it's getting late as well, then it's allowed that they can make a jamaat at home. The imam, the husband could be the imam, or if he has the son who can recite the Quran beautifully and he understands as well, he's mature, he can be also the imam, and the wife and the other children and the daughters, they all can stay behind and make a form of a jamaat, and salah will be valid. Okay,
Jazakallah Shaykh. Thank
Shall
you
we
very
make
much.
A request for the background? Or?
Oh, yeah, dear viewers, we'd like to apologize that we are having some difficulties at the background, and we do apologize for the background noise. As you know, it's a live program, we cannot minimize it. We'll try to minimize it for the next time. Please bear that, accept our apologies. Thank you very much.
Jazakallah.
Thank you, Shaykh. The next question. It's a very relevant for the today's life. Is it allowed to have Quranic verses on mobile screen? Mobile means any screen. It okay. could be the computer screen. It could be the tablet screen or mobile
Mashallah,
screen.
Very nice question. A very relevant question. That is it allowed to have Quranic verses saved on the mobile screen as a screensaver, either on the mobile, on the iPad, on the laptop, or whatever parts people have nowadays? Is it allowed? Very nice question, Mashallah. The answer to that is, first of all, we have to look, why was Quran revealed? Okay, Quran was revealed as a book of guidance, so we take guidance from the Quran. Are you with me? So therefore, Quran should be kept in a way that it is the book of guidance, and I take guidance from it. As far as screensaver is concerned, people put anything on their screen which they like, okay, on their laptop, on their iPads, etc., etc. If people do put it on, it is not haram. It is not haram. Okay? I'm not saying it's haram. However, it's against the respect of the Holy Quran. Quran should be respected. Therefore, if a person has the screen saver as the Quranic verse, either on the mobile or on the iPad or on the laptop, etc., etc., it is allowed. But better not to have it, because Quran is not for that reason. Last year or the year before, ulama, the scholars of Saudi, they were questioned that is it allowed to have Quranic verses as the mobile ringtone? Okay, so the ulama, they gave the fatwa saying that no, it is not allowed, because Quran is not to make the ringtone of a phone. Okay, Quran is a book of guidance, so it should be taken care into that consideration with the respect and with the dignity. So therefore, Quran or the verses of the Quran should not be made as a ringtone, or it should not be left on a screensaver as a display. However, it is not haram. If somebody has done that, it's not haram. It's just not better. Okay, better way of respecting the Quran is not to have it like that. Okay, have the Quran. You can have in your mobile. You can have a Quranic app. The whole Quran is there in one app. So if you want to recite the Quran, just press the app like we do. Press the app for the Facebook, press the app for the WhatsApp or the Twitter. So we just press that app and we have the whole Quran in front of us, and we can flick the page as well, etc., etc. So we can have the whole Quran in there as an app. And we need, whenever we need to open the Quran, we can open it from there and read the Holy Quran. But not as a screensaver. For example, if a person has gone to the bathroom and somebody has rang him or somebody has texted him, then what will happen? And the light will blow in the phone, and then the Quranic ayat is visible. He's in the bathroom, and the Quranic ayat is visible. Therefore, due to all these things, ulama, they say it's better not to have it, okay, on the screensaver as Quranic verse. However, to have an app is allowed.
Jazakallah. Okay. Thank you very much for your wonderful answer and elaborated answer. So, third question is about if a person did not sit after the second rakah in salah, what should he do?
Okay, mashallah, nice question as well. That if a person is praying salah which has more than two rak'ah, for example, zuhr, asr, isha, or even maghrib as well, and they meant to sit down after second rak'ah, either he or she, they never sat down for the second rak'ah, they stood up erect for the third, what do they do? Mashallah, very nice question. The answer is very simple. When you sit down for the fourth rak'ah at the time of tashahud, you recite tashahud. At-tahiyyatu lillahi wa salawatu wa tayyibat. You recite it fully. And then after that, you turn your face towards your right, saying assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. And after that, go sajida again. And perform two sajida, which are known as sajida sahwa. Sajida for rectifying the mistake we made earlier on. Okay? After doing the two sajida as normally we do in the salah, sit down again and then recite tashahud, and then salah ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, Allahumma barik ala Muhammad, and then the dua masura, any dua you want, Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathira, that dua or any other dua, and then finish the salah is normally by saying assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So this is the procedure. If somebody did not say it on the four rakah salah for the first sitting, he stood up by mistake, then the answer to that question is, to make that mistake is by two sajida sahwa at the end of the salah after tashahud, saying assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, do sajida, two sajida, and then sit down again, and then finish the salah normally, and at the end say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, salah is done.
Thank you, Shaykh, and we'll move to the next questions. Who is responsible for looking after parents, the son or the daughter-in-law?
MashaAllah. Someone has asked very nice question, MashaAllah, and this is a very relevant question, very relevant as well. It's related to Islamic family law, that who is responsible for looking after the parents? Is it the son, i.e. the husband, or the daughter-in-law? Very nice question, Allahu Akbar. Jazakallah for the person who has asked this question, that who is responsible for looking after the parents? Is it the son, i.e. the husband, or is it the daughter-in-law? Jazakallah khair. The answer is, in principle, the person who look after the parent is the husband, because they are his parents. Okay? Therefore, as the husband, he looks after the parents because they are his parents, and it's a duty on him. However, my brothers and my sisters, because our nikah, the marriage, is a mutual contract, is to support one another. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has said in the Holy Quran, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, that help one another for the virtuous acts, and do not help one another for the evils, for the crimes, for the sins. Okay? Now, as husband and wife combined together, okay, after the nikah, after the ijab and qubul, after the agreement, okay, and after the dowry, everything took place. Now, as husband and wife, we live together. Okay? All the difficulties of the life, all the enjoyment of the life, we share as husband and wife. Okay? Sharia says at that time, be understanding, rather than just picking the own duties. This is yours, this is mine. Okay, we have had the lunch tonight. Okay? Now you're going to wash the plates, I'm going to wash the dishes. You're going to wash the glasses, I'm going to wash the jug. Now do not be like that. Be a family. Don't be selfish. Don't just categorize the duties. I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. No, do everything together. I do everything together, you do everything together. Okay? Help one another. This should be the motive, that we are here to support one another. This is why in the Quranic concept, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, as husband and wife, Hunna libasul lakum wa antum libasul lahun. They are your clothing and you are their clothing. Meaning that whatever you do, you support one another. Now normally what happens is that the husbands, they work out, okay, for 8 hours, they're out, okay? Now at that time, the wife is left at the house, okay? At that time, wife should consider that my husband comes after 8 hours of working, okay, he's tired. So meanwhile, in his absence, if I do look after his parents, I am looking after the elderly people, Allah Azza wa Jalla will definitely grant me the rewards. And if she does so, and this is alhamdulillah in Muslim families, this is the custom. The wives, they look after their father-in-law and their mother-in-law, and they do it, mashallah, wholeheartedly. Are you with me? So they will get a reward because of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifully has said, if a person respects the people in their elderly age, people who reach the old age, if a person respects them and take care of them in their elderly age, Allah will appoint people for that individual when he or she becomes old. Allah will appoint people, they will look after him. Allahu Allah. It's another simple way of saying in English, whatever goes around comes around. If I do respect, okay, people will respect me later on in my life when I become old. Are you with me? So my brother and my sister, this duty of looking after the parents, in principle, is the husband's duty. But husbands, sometimes they're working, they're out of the house, they're doing many of the things for the family. So if the sisters are at home, the wives are at home, and if they are doing it, they're doing a rewardable act, they will get a reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. However, do not make this issue an issue of conflict. The husband should not force his wife, and the wife should not always be selfish as well. Why should I? They're your parents. Should not neglect them as well. Ajudmi, live in the family as supportive to each other, helping one another, which Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Holy Quran, ta'awanu 'alal birri wat taqwa wa la ta'awanu 'alal ithmi wal 'udwan. Help one another for the virtuous things and do not help one another for the evils. Barakallah.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. Thank you very much for wonderful answer. May just add a question into that.
You can add many things.
What about the daughter and the son-in-law's rules into that?
Again, as far as the son-in-law is concerned, he respects his mother-in-law and father-in-law, okay? According to Sharia as well. Whatever they tell him, according to Sharia, he respects. And this is why you see in our custom, subhanallah, being as the son-in-law or being as the daughter-in-law, we get the royal service. We get the royal service. You ask me, whenever we go to our in-laws, we see, subhanallah, it's like the red carpet reception, okay? Just because I am a son-in-law. And especially from the mother-in-law, it comes extra, okay? So they respect us, they love us, okay? And they love why? So we can have a nice connection with their daughter. You hear me? So as far as that is concerned, we should also pay it back to them. We should love them, we should respect them, we should gift them. Because remember one thing, their beloved daughter, they have given her to you for your entire life, subhanallah. And normally fathers, they have the strongest connection with their daughters. The father keeps all the pain, and on the wedding day, he gives her hand to your hand and he gives her to you and take her. Allahu Akbar. So at that time, always remember that this was the biggest bounty given to me from my father-in-law, from my mother-in-law. So as a respect, okay, as being grateful to them, be nice and kind. Many people, again, from the men's side, they be selfish as well. They be selfish. And what is that? No, your father never done this to me. Your mother never does to me. Why do they have to do that to you? They have given the best thing they could, which is your wife. They have given they have done the best thing for you. You need a right spouse, so they have given that to you. So what else do you want from them? So they want to give you a Ferrari every single year. They want to give you a big BMW car every single year. You don't expect that from them. So as far as having kind of like this kind of attitude as well, to have many things from the family of the in-laws, from the father-in-law's side, that's also kind of greedy, which is not Islamic as well, which is against the custom of Sharia, which is in our custom people do as a, na'udhu billah, as a custom and due to negligence and due to jahiliyyah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla protect.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I hope you're not offended because I have spoke against the men this time.
No, no, of course I'm not. It's for the knowledge.
Jazakallah.
Of course. And can we move to the next questions?
Inshallah.
Is it allowed to play recorded adhan from masjid at prayer time?
Subhanallah. Nowadays, very nice question, eh? Mashallah. Very nice question, Kay. Mashallah. Subhanallah. Somebody has asked a question. Is it allowed to play recorded adhan? Okay, CD of adhan, cassettes of adhan, or even in the mobile phones
mobile
as well.
Phone.
So yeah. When the time of adhan is there from the masjid, rather than appointing a muadhin to give live adhan 5 times daily, shall we just put in the timer on the machine,
yeah,
and then the machine does the job? Is it allowed? No, it is not allowed. At the time of 5 daily prayers, live adhan has to be played. Okay, this is the custom. It came down from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam until today, and it will still continue. You hear me? Not the recorded, because recorded is not live, and the command of Sharia is with the live. So when a muadhin says azan, we respond to the words of azan. Okay, and when the muadhin finishes azan, we recite the dua, Allahumma rabba hadhihi da'wati tamma wa salatil qa'ima. And the virtue is related to when the muadhin is giving the azan, not when you are hearing the record. You hear me? This is why many of the things which are recorded, the Sharia command doesn't implement because of them. For example, we are doing the program live now. If I was to recite any verse of the Quran which has sajida in it, if I was to recite that, okay, then those thousands of people are hearing the program now, they had to do a sajida. Why? Because it's a live program. I'm live here. However, if it was recorded, they don't have to, because it's recorded, it's not live. Are you with me? So as far as azan is concerned, it has to be live, and it has to be given from the masjid in the 5 daily prayers, not from a machine that it plays during the and time is set and it plays during the 5 daily prayers. This is the custom came down from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that azan is always live.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. But what we should do while we listen the azan from through television or radio, because they play a recorded azan?
Okay, if you see from the television and radio, that's a recorded azan. You don't have to respond to that. That's however, if you see from like in the Ramadan, when you do collection in IQRA TV, we do live azan.
Live azan.
Maghrib azan time. So if the live azan is going, you can see the muadhin doing the azan. At that time, you respond. Okay? However, if it is recorded, then there is no need to respond.
But they can follow the timetable of the Adhan, right?
According to their city.
City.
Okay, definitely. If they're in London, they can listen to the Adhan of London televisions and do their Iftar and Maghrib Salah. But if they're in Glasgow, they can't. Because Glasgow is after probably 15-20 minutes. Are you with me? And if they are in Finland, if they are in France, not according to London.
No.
Are you with me? According to their own cities.
Yes, times, yes, and yes. Local times.
Of course. Yes. So for example, our program is broadcasted all over the world. Now if somebody is watching from Fiji Island, for example, now probably their time is totally different than ours. It's not their Asr time going to be, or it's not going to be their
Maghrib. I think it's 14 hours plus there. So, Jazakallah Sheikh, thank you very much. The next question we have, why people have constant problems in life?
Oh, mashallah. Why people have constant problems
before
in life?
Before answering the questions, I would like to take a call. Please allow
me. Of course, you can. Dear
caller, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, brother.
Yes, sister,
I was just listening to your program regarding the Adhan. Hello, can
yes.
you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you properly, please.
Okay. I just wanted to ask a question. I know the Sheikh said you're not allowed to play recorded Adhan, but sometimes being a woman and obviously you can't hear the Adhan, is it? What I do normally is play the Adhan during the Adhan time. Is that allowed for, permissible for a woman to sort of
listen
to it and, you know, respond to the Adhan? Is that something recommended? Do you get any reward, or does it not matter if you play it? Or if you could answer that question.
So okay, Jazakallah, sister. Thank you very much for your wonderful questions. Do you have any other question?
No.
Okay. Jazakallah. Thank you very much. Our Sheikh will answer that. Yes.
Okay. The answer to that was related to playing the Adhan for a masjid.
Masjid.
Okay. When the masjid, they have the minaret, and many masjid in England, we have the scanner system. From the masjid, we have the scanners, and from the masjid, Adhan is given, then the Adhan, live Adhan, comes to our houses. Because in England, we are not allowed to give Adhan openly in many places, many of the cities of England. So at that live Adhan time, we are not allowed to play any recorded Adhan from the masjid, which comes through the scanners or the radios or the masjid channel or from the minaret. We are not allowed to do it recorded. We have to do it live. However, if a sister, just to make herself aware of the salah time, she doesn't have the access to that radio, she doesn't have the access to that scanner, okay? Or nor she can hear the live adhan. So what she has done, she put her alarm clock in the timer, or she has put the adhan in her mobile phone in the timer. Now, according to the time of salah comes, the mobile phone rings as adhan, okay? That is considered. That is just like to inform you that you are entering the time of salah. So that's allowed. But playing it from the masjid, not the muadzin himself doing it, record it, that's not allowed. This is what I meant.
Okay.
Jazakallah.
It's been cleared, I think.
Alhamdulillah.
It's been wonderful. We have a caller on the line. Let's take the call. Assalamu alaikum, dear caller.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes.
I like your program. It's so nice and so beautiful. And I just want to ask one more thing. I'm a cab driver myself. If I want to, sometime I couldn't come home, or sometime, you know, mosque is very far. So if I do in a car, is it all right to do it in a car? Because, and take the shoes off and just do the inside the car. Is it all right to do the prayer?
We understand your questions. And do you have any other question?
Allah, what surah will be to
take
it to close to Allah? Thank you.
Okay, Jazakallah. Thank you very much. Yes, Sheikh.
The brother has asked a very nice question, that sometimes he's in the car and he's away from the masjid. By the time he goes to the masjid, he'll miss the jamaat, or the time will run out. Is he allowed to pray within the car? Very nice question. The answer is, my brother, as far as standing in salah is concerned, is farad, is compulsory. And we cannot leave that or miss that unless we have a valid reason. That a person cannot stand up, he's disabled, or he or she, they have the severe pain on their legs. They cannot do so. Okay? Then it could be considered. For a person who can get off the car, for a person who is physically fit, who can stand up, for them the command of Allah will implement, which is وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. That in salah, stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla with due respect. Therefore, for you to pray in the car is not valid, brother. Please don't be offended. You have to go out of the car and then stand on the ground and pray your salah, because standing in salah is compulsory. Okay? Second reason is that because it's your own car, you can stop wherever you want, you can drive whenever you want. Okay? Therefore, he has to get off from the car to do it.
Okay.
Thirdly, let me just finish. Thirdly, if he's on the public transport, for example, he's on a train, he's on a coach, he's in a plane. Now, it's not his own choice to get out of the transport by himself. For that person, ulama, they have said, if he cannot make his cannot reach to his destination before the time of the salah ends, because it's going to become qada, Therefore, it is allowed. If he cannot stand up, then he can sit down on the seat and do it. But for this case, the brother, the way he asked, because he is doing his own car, he can get off whenever he wants, he can stop and drive whenever he wants. Therefore, for this person, for this brother, it will not be allowed. He has to get off, stand up, and then pray the salah. Sorry,
just if it's if he needs to go outside, if it's the weather condition is not good enough, what does he should
at that time look for the nearest place, dry place, and go there and pray the salah.
Okay, so
because the you know, the motive of the Sharia is that whatever command Allah has given, try your level best to fulfill that and do it. Okay, so standing in salah is one of the most important thing. Allah says waqumu lillahi qanitin, stand with Allah with respect. Okay, now if it's raining, for example, then we can drive and go to the next service station, go to the drive, and nowadays we have the masjid app as well. The apps in the iPhones and the smartphone, they tell you where the nearest local masjid is. Okay, so we can find that, and inshallah we can go to the local masjid. Okay.
Thank you, Jazakallah, Shaykh. Thank you very much for answering these questions. And we also have a caller on the line. Let's take the call. Assalamu alaikum, dear caller.
Assalamu alaikum.
Welcome, salam.
Thank you very much for accepting my call. Very, very nice program and very, very big.
Thank you.
One of the best, I think, and he is a only of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you know, I'm calling from the detention, and I just wanted to one request to the Sheikh. Please do some dua for me. This is the only reason I call for you, because I know that if you make a dua for me, then it will be accepted, because you are very, very pious, man, and, you know, really grateful to watch your program.
Jazakallah.
Thank you very much, dear caller. Thank you very much. We'll definitely do dua for you, and also we'll request our audience to do the dua for you. And also, Jazakallah, we are very end of our today's program, and we do have one last question. And the question is, there's a government scheme to support people with a grant of the amount is 25,000. Is it allowed to take it with the intention of not
paying it?
So I think you are not returning it. Yeah,
okay. Sorry. The current government in England, they have a scheme. I've done the full research about it. There's a scheme that government wants to support people with £25,000. So anyone who wants to, who are eligible, who wants to bring that pound from the, that money from the government, government will allow them. Now, but they have to have meet some criteria and meet some conditions. Now, the person is asking that is it allowed to bring that money with the intention of not paying back or making some fake papers to be eligible to have that money and then bring it, etc., etc. Okay? So the answer to this question is that if the government is giving any kind of fund as a loan, first of all, bear in mind, it's going to be definitely based on interest. Okay? It's not going to be never with the interest. It's definitely going to be with interest. Therefore, we are not allowed to bring that money with the interest if there is no any valid need. And I say in converting to my valid need, okay? That it is not allowed. Number two, to have that money with the intention of not paying back. Okay, like I think that one of the conditions of the government is that if you are not earning £25,000, if it is less, you don't have to pay that. Okay, so with the intention, okay, I am earning 35, but I'll show government I'm earning 20, so I'll never have to pay that money back to the government. Okay, or with the intention or making the fake documents to be eligible to bring that money from the government and then have it, okay, etc., etc. So, whoever has asked this question, my brother or my sister, very nice question, it is not allowed. Because as a Muslim, telling lies and deceiving is totally haram. Doesn't matter if you are deceiving a Muslim or a non-Muslim. Okay, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, "Man ghashshana falaysa minna." Who deceives us, he is not amongst us. In another hadith, he says, "Al-mu'minu la yakdhib." Unbeliever, he never tells lies. Now, to have the intention of not paying back and you are eligible to pay back, that's a deceiving haram. Okay, and not eligible but producing the fake documents to receive it, that's haram as well. Therefore, it is totally not allowed. May Allah Azza wa Jalla grant us the ability to understand properly, sincerely, to practice, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to deceive and harm anybody. Barakallah. Okay.
Jazakallah, Sheikh. Jazakallah, Sheikh. We are at the very end of our today's program. Okay. I would like to request you to summarize our today's topic, the missing salah, within a minute, please.
Barakallah. My brothers and my sisters, as far as Salah is concerned, it's one of the main pillars of Islam, and missing the Salah is considered one of the major sins. So let's repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and from now on, let's be really sincere to Allah Azza wa Jalla, loving to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and be punctual with our Salah, inshallah. Please continue to watch our programs, inshallah, live, and then on Facebook as well, and inshallah, soon on YouTube as well, inshallah, will be live, inshallah. So just to propagate the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and convey the message of peace and love to the entire humanity. May Allah Azza wa Jalla grant us the ability to fulfill the command of Allah Azza wa Jalla and convey His message of love and peace to the entire humanity. Barakumullah khair.
Jazakallah Shaykh, thank you very much for being here today, and also we'd like to thank on behalf of our audience to you. Thank you very much once again. Dear viewers, we are at the very end of our today's show. We do not have any more time. We invite you for the next week for that Islam and Life at the same time, same channel, and also please pray for us and take care. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.